Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's learn some new Finder tips, tricks, and techniques that you could use every day. I couldn't do MacMost without a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So let's jump right into it. You probably already know how to create a new folder. You go to File, New Folder, and once you have a new folder, you can move items into it. But you could also select multiple items. I'm going to hold the Command key down to select multiple files here. And then you can go to File, New Folder with Selection. That will create a new folder and instantly move all of the selected files into that folder. Now if you want to get information about a file, you can select it and use Command I or File Get Info to open up a window for that file. But if you want to get info in another file, you have to select that file and use Command I again there. And you actually end up with multiple info windows open, one for each file. But you can also use an inspector, and an inspector will change depending upon what file you have selected. So that's the same menu item, but instead of Get Info, you hold the Option key down and it changes to Show Inspector. So Option Command I. So with a file selected, you do Option Command I. It looks like the Get Info window, except it has a smaller bar at the top letting you know it's a palette window that will remain on top and stay there. So now I can select a different file and you can see it changes to show information about that file. Now if you want to get the full path to a file, you can do it one of three ways. One way to do it is to hold the Command key down and click on the window title here, and that will give you a list going all the way up to the top level. You can also go to View and then Show Path Bar and then see the path at the bottom of the window. You can also go to View and then Customize Toolbar and then drag and drop the Path button in to the toolbar like that. Then you can click there and get a list going all the way up. Now let's say you want to navigate up a level. You can use this Path button here. You can Command click on the title there and select something there, or you can double click on any item you see here in the path bar. But an easier way to go up one level is to use Command Up, which is Go in Closing Folder. So Command Up takes you up a level. Now I showed you the path bar. There's another bar at the bottom as well. You can turn that on with Show Status Bar, and this will give you information like how many items are selected, how many items are in the current folder that you're viewing, and the amount of space available on your drive. In addition, you get a handy little slider here that allows you to change the size of the icons in the current view. And this only works in icon view, so you see it goes away if I go to list view or column view. Now when you create a new Finder window with Command N or File New Finder Window, it will go to a certain location. You could set that by going to Finder Preferences, and there under General you have New Finder Windows Show, and you can choose all these different folders and even other and choose any folder that you want to be the default location for a new Finder window. Now when in list view, notice that folders and files are intermingled depending upon how you have things sorted. So here I'm sorting by name. You can tell because the little arrow is there in the name column. But if you go to Finder Preferences and then go to Advanced, you can change it so that folders are kept on top but only when sorting by name. So select that and now see that these folders are here on top. If I change the sorting by something else like Date Modified, you'll see that's no longer the case. Also in column view, you'll see it puts the folders there at the top as well because column view is always sorted by name. Now one problem in column view is sometimes the columns aren't wide enough to fit files with longer names, and sometimes they're too wide and there's a lot of blank space there. You can drag the line between columns to adjust it, but if you double click on the line it will snap to be the perfect size. And if you hold the Option key down and double click on any of the line, it will do it for all of the columns at once. Now this also works in list view. If I go to list view, notice how much space here I have for the name column. So I can adjust by dragging the line here at the top, but also I can double click it and it will then snap to the perfect size for that column. And while we're here in list view, you can add more columns to this by going to View, Show View Options. And you're going to get Show Columns here. And you could add all sorts of different columns like different dates, versions, all sorts of different things that can be included there. So you can customize this to have the exact columns that you want. Notice too that you can adjust the icon size here, so I can make it a larger icon, and I can adjust the text size as well. And you could do that in all the different views. So I can go to the icon view and adjust icon size there and text size there as well. The same thing for column view. I can adjust the text size there to make it larger text in column view. Now everybody knows how to use undo. When you're working in a word processor, for instance, you delete some text, you use undo to get the text back. But undo works in the Finder as well for all sorts of different actions. So for instance, say I take this file and I move it into this folder. I can now go to Edit Undo or Command Z and it will come back here to this level. I can do the same thing with renaming a file. I can rename it and decide that was a mistake, and I can do Command Z and undo the rename. Even deleting a file, I can select it and drag it to the trash or do Command Delete to throw it away, and I can do Edit Undo to get it back. Now the trash also has an undo built into it. If I go to the trash here and I look at what I have in the trash, I can select a file and then go to File and then Put Back. And Put Back will actually return the file to wherever it was when I deleted it. So I don't have to remember the exact location and drag it out of the trash to that. I could just use Put Back to get the file back to where it was originally and out of the trash. Now if you want to duplicate or move files around, you can certainly do that with dragging and dropping. But you can also use copy and paste. You can select a file like this and you can do Edit Copy or Command C. And then we can go to another location here, go into that location, and then do Edit and Paste Item. And that will make a copy of it here. If I hold down the Option key, then Paste changes to Move Item here. So Command V will paste a copy of it, and Option Command V will actually move the original item to the new location. Now I already showed you an example of customizing the toolbar, but another way you can customize the toolbar is by adding files, folders, or even apps to the toolbar. So for instance, if I wanted to add this file to the toolbar, I could hold the Command key down and drag it up here, and you could see a plus button appears. And if I put the file there, I can open the file now by clicking on it in the toolbar. I can Command drag and bring it all the way down to remove it. I could do the same thing with a folder. I can Command drag the folder up there, and now I can drag things into the folder or click on the folder once to actually go to that location. You could also add applications to the toolbar. Just go and Applications to see all your applications. Then pick an app that you want to use to open files with. So for instance, I could pick BB Edit. I hold the Command key and drag it to the top, and now it's in there. And now I can open that file by dragging it to that icon in the toolbar. A lot of times things get messy. We have different windows with the Finder on it here, and we can merge all of those into tabs by going to Window and Merge All Windows. And this puts all of the open Finder windows into different tabs. So it's a good way to clean things up without closing Finder windows. Now if you have a messy folder like this one, you can do a one-time cleanup by using View and Cleanup or Cleanup By. And then you can choose how you want it to clean up. So I can do by name, and it's going to clean it all up, put them all in order one after the other in the grid, all sorted by name. I could also choose Sort By and then choose name, and it will keep things sorted. So for instance, if I were to change this file name here, you could see it's going to move everything around to keep everything in alphabetical order. But remember to go back to Sort By None if you want to then arrange things any way that you want. Now you probably know that if you go to Column View, you get a preview window here on the right. So anything you select is then going to be previewed there. But you can get that in other views as well. So for instance, I can go to List View here and go to View and then select Show Preview. And now you can see that same preview there on the right. And I could do the same thing even in Icon View. You could see it appears there. So you can toggle that on and off with View, Show, or Hide Preview. If you're looking at things in List View, you'll notice that a typical column to have is size. But size only shows for files. For folders, you don't see a size. But you could turn that on by going to View and then Show View Options. And then there's a checkbox for Calculate All Sizes. Once you turn that on, then you see all the sizes for folders. And when you sort by size, it'll put the folders properly in their place according to size. Now let's say you've added a bunch of items to the trash, but you want to review them first before emptying the trash. However, there's a file you really want to delete right now. You can skip the trash by selecting a file and then going to File, and you'll see here where it's Move to Trash or Command and the Delete key. But if you hold the Option key down, that changes to Delete immediately. So Option, Command, Delete will delete that file immediately, skipping the trash and leaving all the files that are currently in the trash right where they are. Now we're always looking for ways to differentiate files and folders from each other. A handy way to do so is to use emoji in file names, because you can use any characters you want here. So I have a folder here, and certainly I can use regular letters and numbers, but I could also use Control Command Space to bring up the emoji viewer and add any emoji I want to this folder name. So for instance, I can search for something that makes sense, like a speaker icon here for an audio file, and I could add it in, and now it makes it a little bit easier to find that folder. And I could do that with all my folders and files if I want. And one last tip here. A lot of us forget that we have items in the trash. We'll throw items away and then we'll plan to go through them later. But the trash ends up filling up and our hard drive runs out of space. You can set up the trash so that when files have been in there for 30 days, they're automatically deleted. Just go to Finder Preferences and then go to Advanced, and there's an option here to remove items from the trash after 30 days. This is definitely something I use. It still gives you a safety buffer of 30 days for anything you put into the trash, so you can undo any mistakes, but it also means that you don't have to remember to empty the trash. So I hope you learned a few new ways to use the Finder to manage your files and folders. If you have a favorite Finder trick that I didn't mention, share it with everybody below in the comments. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.